Dot, 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 what's the protocol? Running back, yeah.
Hoff Doncaster, I think it was a national. When my dad gets something in his head, he's like full on with it. I don't know where he got it from, but power naps become a thing. So my dad's like, right, get in the van now, have a power nap. So I'm in the van now, trying to snooze, right? And I got this handbrake wedged into my back. I bump it in gear and just drop the handbrake. All of a sudden, I can hear Marie start screaming, right? Looks up, we're rolling down the hill, right? Right, the van must have bumped out the gear. All easy up and everything's dragging along with it. Boozing and Zag tied to the tow hitch on the back. All right, get tagged down here. Like, I'm trying to pull the handbrake up. The handbrake isn't working, right? It's just fully passed out. Ends up going across the track and like over the finish line. It was absolute uproar. Rode over somebody's bike, over their wheel. My dad had to buy a new wheel for this guy.
Still race?
Oh yeah, of course I did, yeah.
Power nap done.
Power nap was done, yeah. Probably done crap, yeah. I'm Ajay Jones.
Yeah.
I like long walks on the beach. Nah, I'm from South Wales. Fat, hairy ass plumber by the day. Like to ride bikes in the night. Like digging. Like moaning about things, like cooking. Got like a clothing brand called Les Avio. I just always riding motorbikes and push bikes. It got to about 11, 12, I think it was, something like that. I hurt my back, I slipped my disc. So I was in hostel for like 2 weeks. My stepfather, he rides motocross as well. He brought a magazine in for me. There was no motorbike magazines there. So he brought me in the second ever edition of Dirt. It had this picture of Palmer on the front. And I didn't know who Sean Palmer was. He was just sick, like he had a pair of Vans on, like sick helmet with a big fin on the back. For me to see that for the first time, these big triple cam forks. And I was just like, that's unreal. I was like, I need to do that. In that magazine, it was a race series called Dragon Downhill. And me and my dad just rolled up to this first race. I literally didn't know what I was getting myself in for. I thought I was the boy on the bike, you know, jump 10 breeze blocks, you know, the ramp against it. I was like, oh, I'm the kid, I'm gonna go there and smash it. And I get there and I like V brakes. So all the loam was coming up again, stuck in my V brakes. So I was going so slow. I had to stop and like move my, like, get all the crap up and we'll go again. Like, but I just loved it. I come last, but I just absolutely loved it. All the people there were really friendly. That girl didn't mean much to me. Head high, walking on down the street. That guy looks like he needs. I just like really loud things and want to be different. I always want to be different to everyone else. I just don't want to be like the average Joe. Like, I just want to do my own thing and have my own style. So in 2005, I stopped racing. I think kind of stopped enjoying it. I was like into music and I just wanted to be in a band. Anyway, I seen an advert online somewhere, but I was supposed to go to the band practice to play bass, but I didn't want to play bass. I wanted to be a singer. I took my mate along with me and he's a guitarist, so I got him to play the bass. And then I sung and that was the start of the band. So in 2009, we wrote this record. And no one was interested in releasing the record. So I started my own record label called Purgatory Records. And momentum started building. We released this record, Root of All Evil. That was the start of like the band getting bigger and bigger. And yeah, we just kept on playing shows, more tours, traveled all across Europe, UK, everywhere, been to every like nook and cranny. We was at a point where we were as big as we were gonna get with me pushing it and still on my label. The band just started going in the wrong direction, so I left. And the boys carried on, but yeah. What's your life like? Les Avio started with my mate, like, he was like, come on, hey, let's have you. Just amped up, just like, get to the top of a climb, smash everywhere, like, let's have you. And it kind of just stuck. People just caught onto it and started hashtagging it, let's have you. So we printed up a few t-shirts, like 50 t-shirts, and just sold them like locally, but like they just went like the first day, like everyone had them. It's just like snowballed, and like Marie was like, oh, let's try and make it a bit bigger. So Marie, is her full-time job is doing Less Avio, and she just does all the admin side of it, and like all the posting, sewing, ordering, everything. Marie just does everything now. She's the boss. So June this year, I was diagnosed with Addison's disease. I was really fit at one point, and I got like unfit, just getting worse and worse and worse. Couldn't descend, couldn't go uphill, couldn't leave the house. Any riding I have done in the last year, I've had to get an uplift to the top, and then I maybe could like ride one little section for like an Instagram clip or something. So I kept on going back and forth to the doctors and having blood test after blood test. The doctor was telling me I was okay. There was nothing wrong with me. I knew that my body wasn't right. It got to a point where I was getting like so bad, man. I was like, couldn't function like at all. So I booked myself back into the doctors, and I went, and luckily I seen a different doctor. And as soon as I sat down, like, she told me exactly what's wrong with me. Next day I go straight in for a blood test, 7:30. I was out for like an hour, then hospital rings me and get rushed into hospital. And I spent like 8 days in hospital. I know what's wrong with me now. I know I can just go to sleep and come back and recharge. But yeah, I'm just happy. Positive part, I'm back at riding, working on my fitness. I think this is the third week. I went out last night and my mate Dutchie was like, oh, I can't believe how much you progressed in a week.
Is it my fault? God has got the love for that.
Just super happy again, like buzzing on life, like happy to be out riding. Like, future goals for me, get back fit, fast. Trail building, doing all the cool stuff I used to. I got a baby on the way. I'm stoked to be a dad. Can't wait for all that to go on. Like, just can't wait to like bring this little youth up and just be happy. Like, yeah, just be stoked on life.
I know I've got a life of being honest. She helped me through the ditch. Yeah, she gave me that assist. We're soon to be hitched, and I'm ready like a novice. I love her to the core. I don't need to tell her more. I put the music on pause till I'm ready. That is solid. You never know you need until you realize you won. Or unless you're staring down the barrel of.
That's a wrap.
I said you never know you win until you realize you won. Let's get together, yeah. Let's see what we become.